Welcome to the class 7 students. This is the continuation part of the chapter allergies. In my previous video, I discussed with you till the topic of treatment of allergy, that means what type of treatments or medications are needed if a person has symptoms of severe or mild or moderate allergy. Okay, so let's continue with the next topic today, which is some common allergies. So we will talk about some common allergies, their symptoms, why they occur, and how we can prevent those allergies. Okay, so the first and the most common one is hay fever. Okay, now what is hay fever? Look at the book. It is a most common type of allergy. The name hay fever was coined as it was considered to be caused by pollen grains in hay fields. Okay, so initially it was thought that the pollen grains from the hay fields cause this type of allergy or this type of fever, and that is why the name hay fever. Okay, but later it is now known that it can be caused by any pollen grain, okay, of any plant, not particularly of hay fields. Clear? In addition to pollen grains, hay fever can also be caused by the hairs of pet animals, dust, mites and molds. Okay, so hay fever, initially, although the name came because people thought that this type of disease only occurred from the pollen grains of hay fields, but now it is known that it can be caused by pollen grains of any plant, and apart from pollen grains, it can also be caused by the hairs of the pet animals that we have at our home, dust, mites and molds. Okay, and the other name of hay fever is allergic rhinitis. This is very, very important. Allergic rhinitis is the other name of hay fever. Okay, very important this one. Next, coming to the symptoms of hay fever: runny nose, itchy eyes, mouth or skin. Okay, the mouth, the eyes, the skin, everything becomes itchy. Sore throat. Sore throat means pain in the throat, and coughing. Stuffy nose due to nasal blockage or congestion. Means stuffy nose means one cannot breathe properly through the nose, as the nasal passage has been blocked due to congestion, maybe due to deposition of mucus or something like that. Difficulty in breathing due to stuffy nose. So if the stuffy nose is there, obviously there will be difficulty in breathing. Decreased sense of smell and taste. So even in normal cough and cold, when we suffer from normal cough and cold or we catch a cold, we see that we don't get the smell or taste of food or any other things easily. Okay, we don't have the taste in our mouth. So similarly, in this case also, in hay fever also, the sense of smell and taste is decreased. And the last symptom is asthma. Okay, means you all know what is asthma. People have difficulty in breathing. Okay, so these are all the symptoms of hay fever or allergic rhinitis. You need to learn at least 4 to 5 symptoms for your exam. Okay, talking about the next one, this is also very common: dust allergy. Dust allergy causes breathing difficulty, which sometimes can cause symptoms of asthma such as wheezing, coughing and shortness of breath. It can be caused by dust alone or mite or cockroach excreta or hairs of pet animals. Okay, so obviously dust allergy will be caused by dust, but some other allergens are also there which can cause this type of allergy, which are mites, cockroach excreta and the hairs of pet animals. Okay, and what are its means, what happens, what are its symptoms? Runny or stuffy nose and nasal congestion means either the nose is runny, that means the nose is dripping, or stuffy nose means the nasal passage is blocked due to congestion. Okay, red, itchy or watery eyes. Sneezing, continuous sneezing is a very common symptom of dust allergy. And wheezing or coughing, and obviously if a person is coughing, then shortness of breath will also take place. Okay, so this is all about dust allergy. Moving on to nettle rash, then third one is nettle rash. Now, what is nettle rash? The other name of it is hives. You have already learned about hives, and the picture of nettle rash is already given in your book, this picture. Okay, so see that the mouth area of this child is swollen. Okay, so this is a picture of the nettle, someone suffering from nettle rash. Okay, it is caused by an allergy to certain food items, medicines or cosmetics. Raised itchy bumps on the skin which are either red or skin color. So this raised itchy bumps which are which can be either red in color or the color of the skin. They resemble bug bites and can appear on any area of the body. They may change shape. Sometimes they are circular in shape, sometimes they are elongated in shape like that, and they move around. That means sometimes they are on one corner of the mouth and the next day we'll find it on the other corner of the mouth. So it says that it moves around, it doesn't move around, but the allergy shows its symptoms at different areas in different times. Okay, disappear and reappear over short periods of time. So only two symptoms are there under nettle rash. So you are going to read two, and you are also going to read what causes this nettle rash, which is certain food items, medicines or cosmetics. Okay, moving on to the fourth one, which is eczema. This is also a very common one. I told you that eczema is any skin condition which is also known as dermatitis, already written in your book. So any skin condition which is long term is known as eczema. It is a common skin allergy. It causes itching of skin leading to redness. So you might see someone, people who has a very tendency always to scratch their skin, and they are not doing it intentionally because they are feeling the irritation in their skin. So they are continuously scratching their skin, and what happens as a result of that, it leads to redness. The area becomes red. Eczema develops due to sensitivity to a particular substance in contact with the skin or to a particular food item. Substances that can cause eczema can be certain cosmetics, soap, washing powders and cheap dyes. It can also be caused by stress. So stress can also be a factor which causes any kind of eczema or dermatitis. Okay, now here you got to know what the causes of eczema are: the cosmetic, soap, washing powder, cheap dyes and stress. Now what are the symptoms? Here symptoms are not specifically written in points. Here this symptom will be itching of skin leading to redness. That's it. No other symptom is given. Itching of skin leading to redness is the symptom of eczema or dermatitis. Okay, so we have discussed four common types of allergy, their causes and their symptoms. I hope you have understood all of you have understood. We still have a few more allergies to be left to be discuss. So we will do that in the next video. Thank you.